In this video, you will learn the structure of the Genvid SDK web streaming layer in the context of the Genvid tank sample. You will be able to edit and customize how viewers can view data being sent from your Unity game client via the Genvid services, as well as sending data back from the web to the game. Now, let's view a live stream with the services and stream running locally. We can see a few buttons and the actual gameplay footage. The Genvid video stream is composed of two layers, the video stream and the Genvid overlay. The video stream is live gameplay captured in real time by the spectator client via the Genvid video component and streamed over the Genvid services. On top of the stream footage is an interactive layer for viewers to engage with the spectator client, which is known as the Genvid overlay. The Genvid overlay provides a few interactive pieces for viewers to engage with. In the top left corner of the video, we can see a toggle map button. If you click that button, you can see a top-down map of the game arena and the tanks. As the tanks move around, you can see that the map updates to show the relative position of the tanks. Clicking the toggle map button again hides the top-down view of the game from the overlay. To the right of the toggle map button, you can see a series of buttons allowing you to vote for the next loot drop. Repeatedly clicking a button for a particular vote will allow the loot with the most votes to spawn. And lastly, towards the bottom of the video player, you can see banner buttons. Clicking on the colored banner displays a panel which shows the respective colored tank statistics, such as health, shots fired, shots hit, accuracy, current active buff, and the number of cheers. You can click on the actual tank in the video overlay to see the same information too. Inside the banner button is another button with a thumbs up icon. This button allows you to cheer for your favorite tank, and clicking it displays a text overlay of cheering for a tank. If you choose to, the players of the game are able to also see interaction data from the viewers. In this case, cheers show up as hearts on the game side. If you draw your attention to the center of the screen towards the billboard, you will notice a graphic stating "You're at here." If you look over at the actual spectator client, you will notice that the same billboard simply says "Tanks." The Genvid overlay is extensible to allow you to place custom graphics which are aligned to the game camera in order to create unique views for your viewers. So, how does this all work? The Genvid SDK passes data via several types of streams with different use cases. For example, to display the player number label consistently on top of the tank's position is sent over the game data streams. For detailed information about the game data streams, please view the documentation. Let's head over to the Genvid services directory and open up the UnityTS TypeScript file. The data we retrieve from the spectator client for the web stream is structured in the iGame data interface on line 30. The web stream retrieves JSON data and parses it into the structured interface format. This operation is performed in the on_streams_received function on line 596, which is registered to the constructed Genvid client when a viewer joins the stream. Data found in the game data streams, such as the iTank data interface, are used to display information to the viewers, such as the tank's position in the top-down toggle map and the panel with the tank's firing and health statistics. Since there is a delay between the video stream and the actual gameplay, Genvid SDK compensates by synchronizing game data with the video stream. For example, if a viewer wanted to click the tank and view the statistics, without synchronization between game data and the video stream, the viewer would have to try and guess where the tank actually is instead of clicking the tank's position on the video stream. This is done in the on_new_frame function, which is passed as a callback to the client's onDraw function in the UnityTS file. Since the iGame data contains information about the spectator's client's projection view matrix and billboard, we can construct a billboard effect on top of the video stream to display a custom graphic. The custom graphic is currently located in the Genvid services under the web/public/img directory. The camera's projected view matrix of the spectator client is reconstructed in the video overlay via WebGL, and the position of the billboard is updated with the received game data. The texture is then loaded at each rendered frame, drawn at the position of the billboard that was received in the game data stream. To view the specific logic, please see the WebGL section in the UnityTS file. In the same on_streams_received function, the function also processes annotation streams, which represent a one-time, non-persistent event. In the Genvid tank stream sample, the spectator client occasionally just needs to send match state data. Match state data consists of the state ID, round number, and winning tank ID. This can be found in the Unity TS file on line 23. The annotated match state is used to refresh the viewer web stream to display the round number after a tank is defeated. Annotations are updated in the on_new_frame function on line 361 in the Unity TS file. Now, imagine a scenario with a large number of viewers. If viewers are repeatedly clicking loot votes and the data needs to be consumed by the game, the Genvid services would be potentially under heavy load. To ensure that your game is not a victim of its own success with a large viewership, the Genvid SDK employs a technique known as MapReduce. MapReduce is an algorithm which aggregates and maps common data together and reduces the common events into a single structure. This allows the spectator client to consume a single event instead of consuming many events. To define the structure of data and what MapReduce applies to, you can edit the events.json file under the genvidservices/config directory. Once the loot votes data is aggregated and consumed by the game, the spectator client needs to notify the viewer web streams immediately to show the current number of votes per loot. This is retrieved using the Genvid SDK Notifications API. You can find the notification logic to retrieve notification data on line 621 in the Unity TS file. For the Unity integration, please see the GenvidTanks game data stream component, submit loot data function. Periodically, match states need to be sent over from the spectator client to the viewer web stream. Match state data is structured in line 23 of the Unity TS file and contains information such as the state ID, round number, and the winning tank ID. This data is sent over the annotation stream as it does not need to be persistent and represents a one-time event. If you head over to the top right corner of the viewer web stream, you can click the admin button to enter the admin panel. Type in admin for both the username and password. The admin panel uses the Genvid SDK command channel to send commands directly to the game. This is because events are consolidated and reduced before going to the game, while commands go straight to the game unaltered. This allows for direct input to the game, but does not scale to allow for thousands of incoming viewer interactions. From this interface, we can add buffs to a particular player, such as directly providing player 2 with a shield. View the admin Unity TS file and head over to line 143. The buff tank function builds an I command request, which is an ID value pair. The ID allows commands to be mapped directly between the admin panel and the spectator client, while the value allows you to pass in custom arguments such as the tank you want to buff and the type of buff you want to apply. This is the concatenated string value of player number and buff number. This is subsequently parsed as two integers in the GenvidTanks command component over on the spectator client side. Now we've seen how Genvid SDK sends and receives audio, video, and data via the Genvid services, both from and to the Unity game client, and displays them in the web stream for viewers to interact with. This is just the beginning of the creative possibilities that you can build into your game. For more information on Genvid and our technology, please visit us at genvidtech.com. Thanks for watching.